Welcome to the 2021 Tribute to SHERO ceremony, honoring local women who have answered the call to serve in response to the COVID-19 crisis. Although our awards presentation is virtual this year, there is no greater honor for me than to shine a beaming light on the unsung SHEROs of District 9. And we know that there are many, many others, and to them I say thank you. 2020 taught us to reach deep down into the very fiber of our being. The true nature of humanity emerged through each and every one of the ladies that you're about to meet today. What makes these women extraordinary is that during such unprecedented times, rather than staying at home and taking care of themselves and their families, they've laced up their boots and charged full speed ahead to serve our community. Acts of kindness, no matter how big or small, are precisely what we need in our communities as we fight our way through this pandemic. Together, we are all trying to alleviate some of the heavy burden families are facing. Team Price continues to look for ways to be there for our neighbors through emergency food giveaways, diaper distributions, meals for seniors, free masks, and pop-up vaccination sites at our local parks. We're doing everything we can, but we cannot do it alone, which is why we appreciate all these amazing women who have stepped into their power to strengthen the District 9 community, proving that we are absolutely stronger together when we join forces as one. We owe a debt of gratitude to the legions of SHEROs who are leading the way with heart and compassion. So without further ado, let us all welcome our 2021 SHEROs.
Hi, my name is Camille Enriquez, and I'm a Director of Operations at Central Neighborhood Health Foundation. My primary role as Director of Operations is to help structure our facility. Most of our patients who come in here, we want to let them know we care about them. We want to make sure they come back. We want to make sure that they're comfortable with the care that they're receiving from their providers, as well as our staff. So on a daily basis, they come in, we help them to see the doctor, help them with their vital signs. We see if they have any additional needs, if they need transportation, if they need food, if they need clothing. We offer all those resources to them as well. This community suffered a lot during this pandemic because we had to assist our patients and the community with COVID testing and also to educate them on the benefits of them getting tested and also for social distancing. We address the needs of our neighbors during this crisis by offering all the services at Central Neighborhood to the community. We offer COVID testing for them as well as primary care. Community and being a good neighbor is just about caring for the community. And how we demonstrate that we care for the community is by letting them know the services that we offer and also inviting them to see what we have offered for them and have them come in to see the doctor, receive a COVID testing, prescriptions, any needs that they have. I am inspired to give back because I really love seeing the smile on people's faces when the little needs that they have and requests have been addressed. The legacy that I want to leave one day is, number one, you have to treat people the way you want to be treated. And also, whenever there are others in need and we're in a position to help them, that assistance is going to go a long way. The biggest lesson that I have learned is that we cannot take anything for granted. Every little step that was going to able to make us better during this pandemic was really important, and it was crucial in having everyone come together so that we could get rid of the virus and also to get everyone vaccinated.
Hi, my name is Daisy Garcia. I'm a city employee for Department of Recreation and Parks here at Central Park. Park within the City 9 district. I'm also a resident of 42 years. I think it's important that, you know, as residents, we take some responsibility in helping one another. We play a role in our community. What can you do to help out? It could be from helping your neighbor, you know, reaching out to organizations. I mean, there's something that we all can do. The Department of Recreation and Parks opened up the alternative learning centers, where initially we had 24 kids that could participate, and they came and with, you know, taking all the safety precautions, the kids participate in the program and we make sure that they stayed in class. It's been so helpful for families. I'm a grandma. I have 8 grandkids, and one of my daughters lives with me, and also I have custody of 2 boys, so early morning I get up, get ready, make sure the kids, you know, are reminded about getting their Chromebooks and opening up to come into work at 7:30 at the Learning Center until 1:30. And then afterwards, if there is a resilient, we have every Thursday the food giveaway, so we have to go to the program and make sure we get everything going for the community. And in the afternoon, within the safety measurements, I also work for other parks, which is Gilbert Lindsay, and we do have permits where the kids do practice, and my grandkids are there, and I make sure, you know, that I promote that for the community as well. So I have a very good relationship with coaches and, you know, with groups in the community. So it's important for these kids to also have some type of activity, not just being home all the time. We can't do this alone. It has to be a collaboration, neighbors, organizations. It has to be a group effort.
Hello, my name is Dr. Neuman, and I'm the lead physician for the Chronic Disease Management at South Central Family Health Center. My role also here is to run the COVID testing and COVID vaccination clinic. When COVID-19 started back in March, we all was like, what's this? We didn't know what's going on. And then we realized we need to start to test our community. So I got a call from my chief medical officer asking me if I would like to do COVID testing. And I said, yes, where do I sign up? So starting May, we started testing patients. After that, we got lots of positive results came back, either by the nose or by the antibody test. And patients were like, what does this mean? So we had to dispel some of the myths, some of the misinformation. So we really helped to educate our community. With testing sites so far away, it's so difficult for them to drive or even get there transportation-wise. So having the center here is so much easier for our patients. What inspires me to give back? When I was born a twin, and both my sister and I were preemies, and because of the amazing work and love of the doctors and healthcare workers, we're here today. So I want to pay forward. I want to give back to the community. I want to give back to patients who need the medical attention, who needs the doctor's skill to get them through their chronic conditions and make their lives healthier. I want folks to remember me as an authentic doctor who provides patient education and who takes the time to really listen, who really cares what they say, who really wants to understand you're not just a disease, you're a patient, you're a human being. The biggest lesson I've learned is how strong our community is. We're banding together, making a difference, and not only that, being victorious, because we will beat this. COVID-19 is a tremendous hardship, but also a lesson in community strength, community power, community ability to fight no matter what happens. I'm so honored to be recognized for doing something I love. I'm so blessed every day I come to work. I'm like, I'm actually getting paid to do something I really love. And this is truly a blessing and a calling, so I really appreciate that.
SHERO is an indigenous-led organization, intergenerational, co-founded by 2 Zapotec women, Janet Martinez and myself. During the pandemic, SHERO created the Solidarity Fund. It's called Undocu Indigenous Fund to support indigenous people. And since that pandemic, we have distributed $2 million to indigenous people here in LA County. And we've also provided hundreds of pounds of food to indigenous community, as well as vaccination. So far, we vaccinated more than 1,000 people here in South Central Los Angeles. During the COVID campaign for people to get vaccinated, it's been very challenging because a lot of the information out there is not in indigenous languages. So we had to create a team that educates and informs people in different languages, in Quiche, in Nacateco, in different variants of Zapoteco, Mixteco, about the vaccine. That way they make an educated decision. As far as we know, SHERO is the only organization, the only nonprofit created in LA to service indigenous people's human rights. It makes me feel very blessed for having this privilege to being able to access resources that then we share with the community. It's a blessing.
My Hi, my name is Monique Gibbs. I'm a second supervisor for Community Build. What inspires me to give back? During the pandemic, I've realized, not even just the pandemic, that if I have it, it's nothing wrong with giving it. And it's not for a blessing or because I work for these people. I do other things on the side too, far as I go downtown and, you know, it may not be new clothes or, you know, whatever I can do. If I can make some sandwiches and give it away, maybe four or five people, I'm satisfied. During this pandemic, we've had done a lot of food giveaways more than ever. And whatever we can give, whatever we can do, we try to do. They come on certain days and ask, are we gonna give away food? We may not have the food that we give away, but if I have some, you got it. The kids mean a lot to me here. That's my main thing around here in my community, the kids. I try to keep them focused. They need clothes, shoes, if we find a way to do that for them. Just pretty much keep them occupied. We do arts and crafts, like Valentine's Day, St. Patrick's Day. We always have something for them to do. We play games sometimes on Wednesdays. Most of the time when people look at us, they don't know that we do that. So when I can do it, I'm very proud. I would like people to remember me as a kind-hearted person and someone that they can always come to. And if I can help, I will. Just because it's a pandemic, don't mean that our lives are over. We see how many people has left here because of this pandemic. We're still here, so we still have to fight. We still have to keep people safe. This may be the new normal. We never know. I wake up every morning with the train and thought of my mind, how can I be better than I were yesterday?
Hi, my name is Luz Elena Nunez, and I'm a psychiatric social worker at Kedron Community Mental Health. Over the past year, I've seen an increase in the need of mental health services. The COVID-19 pandemic has impacted our families drastically, primarily financially. Many of them were working 2 to 3 jobs, already struggling, and now the income loss has pushed them even further down the poverty line. During the COVID-19 pandemic, I've provided mental health services to those in need, and also have the opportunity to serve as a member of the Zapata Key Neighborhood Council, where we partner with local nonprofits to provide financial assistance via gift cards. We provided PPE to community members and also hosted informational webinars on topics such as housing rights, renters relief programs, and the importance of vaccination. My family arrived here around the 70s, and although there was a language barrier with neighbors, they still managed to communicate. They looked out for each other, they were respectful to one another, and that's something that's very important to me. This is why I continue to serve my community as I continue to grow, not only in my career, but also as a community member in South Central, is to continue to empower, be respectful to one another, and look out for my neighbor. The biggest lesson I've learned during this COVID-19 pandemic has been the importance of mental health. As a mental health professional, I want to focus on destigmatizing the idea of seeking help. I think most importantly, I want people to remember me as someone that pushed them to get involved, to understand where you are now and to see where you want to be in the future. Someone that inspired young girls to be involved in politics and in settings that are not normally welcome to people of color. But most importantly, I want people to remember me as inspiring to those around her. At the end of the day, it's very important for me to believe in myself, and I want to continue to empower and inspire my community to do the same.
Hello, I'm Dell Richardson Price, First Lady of the New Ninth. Honoring our SHEROs has become a tradition that is near and dear to my heart. The women of South LA are so special and deserve much praise and recognition for all that they add to the community, especially over the past year. This cherished time honored event is especially significant to me because as a woman, I understand the role each of us must play on a day-to-day basis. South LA SHEROs, we look to you as a defining example. Your efforts have uplifted our sons and our daughters, giving them the foundation needed to create the world they envision. Let us all look to the examples of the ladies being recognized today and commit to continuing to work together with heart and compassion long after the pandemic is over. And let us not forget our duty to be good and kind to one another. Above everything, be each other's strength before and after the darkness comes. A heartfelt thank you for your ongoing commitment to changing the trajectory of children, families, and seniors in the new night.
Hi, I'm Yanira de la Cruz. I'm the store team leader here at Northgate Gonzalez Market. For me, it was important to first make sure that all my associates as well were safe. We enforced the mask usage. Everybody here had to wear the mask properly. We installed sanitizer throughout the store. We would give our associates every 30 minutes to wash their hands. It was a requirement. We would follow some checklists that we would sanitize our store every hour to ensure that we were making sure that we were cleaning up after the customers. I think for the most part, we were one of the ones that was actually announcing to the public if we ever had a case, so our community was aware if they had shopped in our store. Our company, ones that first rolled out a lot of the CDC measures without being asked to do it. For example, we were the ones that actually implemented for the elders to shop early in the morning, and we gave them their own time, so they had their own space so they can shop comfortable. We always kept somebody at the door sanitizing the carts, making sure that somebody was counting the store, that everybody was wearing a mask. That really helped us a lot because our customers started feeling more comfortable to shop in our store. What inspires me is putting a smile on my customers' face, especially the kids. It's very nice to be recognized in the community as someone that cares, someone that wants to give back. For example, we had the toy drive, even though it wasn't gonna be the same like the previous year before that because of COVID, but with the help of the police department, we actually were able to follow through, and that really helped the kids feel happy because a lot of people weren't celebrating the holidays. I'm glad that I did everything that I could that was at my control to keep my associates safe, and at the same time that they felt that they were in a safe environment to work in. Overall, I love working for Northgate. It's a very good company to work for. The values that we instill, not only in ourselves, but that we follow, it's a big inspiration for us to work even harder and together as a team.
Hi, I'm Dr. Kamala Gibson McGilroy. I'm a pediatric nurse practitioner currently serving as clinical service manager for advanced practice nursing of ambulatory services at Children's Hospital of Los Angeles. I pretty much serve with the advanced practice nurses or nurse practitioners, physician's assistant to help serve their work, right? So it's helping them, you know, cultivate an environment, a culture that empowers them to deliver the best care they can for the patients in the ambulatory clinics at Children's Hospital. You know, I have one of the, you know, nurse practitioners that I serve feel like they've done their best, right? You know, with my help, that they feel heard, that they feel empowered to be the best that they can be, is a good day for me. I was born and raised in Los Angeles County, and so being a good neighbor is, you know, applying my talents, you know, to my neighbor, okay? Being a honest resource, someone that people can trust, it has been very rewarding. I don't know if it's so much an inspiration as more so a feeling of duty. Again, I was born and raised here, and I feel a sense of obligation to give back in a way, by way of medicine, to a community that probably otherwise wouldn't get optimal health care. I hope my legacy would be one of serving those who would otherwise be underserved, and just using my talents to inspire someone, you know, like myself. I'm a girl born and raised in South Los Angeles, and it was looking up to people like myself that, you know, gave me just the spark to know that I could be doing what they're doing.
Hi, my name is Ivette Zacarias. I'm a certified medical assistant here at South Central Family Health Center. I love working in South Central Family Health Center because it's a very busy clinic and we get people of all types. And I like the fact that you get to share stories with different type of person. When I start working here at this clinic, on my second day I was placed in the COVID area and I still working as a medical assistant, and then at the beginning of this year, they put me to the COVID vaccine. What inspires me is my family and the community. And also when people says thank you to me, that makes me do more for them and give, you know, the best of me. Sometimes I'm wearing my scrubs and they just walk up to me, you know, asking for help. They're like, do you know where I can get the vaccine for free? So that way I send them here. I've been helping my community in that way. And a lot of patients, they come back because they trust me. Community for me, it's family. And also it means that we all are in this together. The biggest lesson I've learned from this health emergency definitely is to take care of my family. I know a lot of families, they lost family members due to COVID-19, and that's very sad. So I've learned to appreciate more our community. I want people to remember me as a person who really cares for them and a person who always was willing to help others. And I want people to know or remember me as a person who always was there to help them in any situation. When people say thank you to me, that makes me feel happy and brave to continue helping them.
My name is Tawana Caldwell. I'm working with Community Build as a Safe Passage lead. And Safe Passage is we keep the park safe. I'm born and raised from this community. And as a kid, I always seen a difference between the other communities and over here. As a young girl, I have made up with my mind that I wanted to do something to give back. That was a part of me volunteering, interacting with the kids and trying to motivate them and encourage them to not look at living over here as a bad thing. Through the work of Community Build, we have a grab-and-go food bag, and that's every first and third Thursday of the month at 11 o'clock. So we actually have groceries, fruits and vegetables for the parents. Being a good neighbor to me means supporting each other in hard times and celebrating in good times. It's been a lot of hardship with the kids. I see a lot because they are not being able to go to school, not coming out. The parents are suffering because they don't have enough food. A lot of people have been losing their jobs. The biggest thing that I've learned is a smile goes a long way. Smiling is a good way to show people that you care and it uplifts them. That waving and speaking to strangers and just really, you know, having small conversations with people to just uplift them and encourage them, it puts a smile on their face. That's been really encouraging to see that the people would come out and could get good snacks and water and things to encourage them for the day, because a lot of times they don't really have money. I want people to remember me for smiling, loving and caring for people and sharing. At the end of the day, what makes me happy is knowing that I've put a smile on somebody's face, that I've given them something that they wouldn't have received, by encouraging the kids just to look forward to a better tomorrow, like hope. Giving people hope is what makes me sleep good at night, having hope.
Hi, my name is Irma Arellano. I'm with Volunteers of America, Newton 2 Grid, and I'm the program coordinator. During COVID-19, we collaborate with many agencies. What we do is we get together, we go out to the community, we provide the PPE, we provide resourceful resources from getting blankets, from even for the homeless getting tents. One of the main concerns that we provide on a daily basis is food. You know, during the pandemic, you do learn a lot, and it's been a hard battle for a lot of people. And what you do is it's an eye opener. It's an eye opener because you see the need. You see the need that is so strong here in this area. But when you got Council District 9, you got SEIA, Volunteers of America, you got the GRID program, you got many other programs that come together and we go out there as a team and we provide, then every day when you go home, you feel, I done what I had to do, and you feel good. The main thing to being a good community member or a friend is always the first thing, and that's just remembering humanity. You know, humanity is very important, that we treat everybody equal. If somebody's in need and we can provide or we can do, we go out there and do it. That's what it's about. It's just about being there for somebody that we can. If we can do it, let's do it. You know, what inspires me is because I know what it is to be on the other side. I know what it is to be without. I know what it is when your hard time ends. So my thing is just every day waking up and making sure that I'm kind and that I go out there and that I just, you know what, make one person smile, then I'm okay.
Wow, what an amazing group of SHEROs. These are women, healthcare professionals, essential workers who have stepped up to the plate to serve our community.
Well, all women are SHEROs, but these women are next level SHEROs. They're power bills, brokering power, influence, and grace, compassion, leaving their homes to help others. I respect them so.
Well, next year, I hope that we can have this ceremony in person. But this year, we are virtual, and we just want to, again, thank and acknowledge the tremendous sacrifices that our SHEROs have made, the example they set for our community, and we wish them well in all their future endeavors.